Just under 700 years ago, this small town of Esteia's Jewish quarters was subject to one of the most brutal of attacks, with the perpetrators kidnapping, torturing, and murdering the local Jewish population. This evening, a talk is taking place in the region, using a rabbi's eyewitness accounts of the atrocities as its basis. Locals were invited to come and hear a story from their region that was almost lost to history, untranslated from its original Hebrew for almost 700 years, until José María decided to take the task on.
The most tragic event in the Jewish history of this region was the massacre of Esteia in 1328. It is a subject that has been studied in depth, and I particularly wanted to work on it because the author wrote in Hebrew and it had never been translated into other languages. So we presented a translation of a part of the book for the first time.
The book he translated was the testimony of the rabbi Menachem Ben Zera, whose parents and four younger brothers were murdered during the massacre of 1328.
I became very interested in the subject. The author came from a family of Jews originating in France. When all the Jews were expelled from France in the year 1306, in that same year they managed to arrive to Esteia in northern Spain. Then, in one night, in 1328, a group of French attackers arrived to the town and killed a large part of the Jews there and looted the Jewish quarters.
The marauding anti-Semites will have entered Spain from the south of France, crossing these mountains and stopping at every village they came across, demanding the conversion of Jews to Christianity at pain of death.
The book was a personal testimony. At the time he was 18 years old, he was studying, and his father was also a rabbi. And he recounts that he was tortured like everybody else. And thinking that he was dead, they left him among the dead bodies. I come from the world of the Bible. I studied in Rome, in Jerusalem. I'm from that world. With modern Hebrew, I went to Nazareth, and the studies that I carried out were always in the field of the Bible. But after retiring, I became interested in this rabbi, as I had the linguistic background.
Often the Spanish landscape prior to the Inquisition is painted as a moment of tranquility and coexistence between cultures. Does tonight's talk contradict this idea?
Well, that's a distorted image. In reality, they all live together, but the Jews were always an unrecognized and persecuted minority. The monarchy treated them well because they had a personal interest. The Jews contributed a lot to the region's finances. And at that point, they were the king's subjects and were therefore protected by him.
Despite the brutality of the attacks, it was not enough to destroy the spirits of the survivors here, with the rabbi being a case in point, moving on to the town of Toledo to become an important rabbi in the country at the time. This is Paul Walsh for JM1, Spain.